Hello and welcome to all for this OSA session. Am I audible to all of you? Anyone can reply in the chat box. Am I audible? Yes, okay. Thank you. So, dear student, yesterday we completed the user's perspective. User's perspective is nothing but what are the high level features of Unix operating systems. So basically there are three high level features of Unix operating systems that comes under the user's perspective of Unix operating systems. So see, we are in the third article, that is system structure and user's perspective. So this user's perspective is nothing but the high level features of Unix operating system. So what are the high level features of Unix operating systems? So there are three high level features. First one is nothing but the file systems. Okay, see, quick review or quick recap of our subject or our syllabus, whatever we completed so far, that I will show you quickly general overview why Unix becomes so popular. Then the history of the Unix operating systems right from 1969 in the Bell Laboratory, what happened with Ken Thompson and Dennis Ritchie. And then up to the 1991 where the Linus Torvald developed the Linux operating systems. So all these things are summarized here in this slide. Okay. Then comes the architecture of the Unix systems where four layers are there. Innermost layer is the hardware layer. Outermost layer is the application program or the end user. Okay, so this is the perspective. So high level features of Unix operating systems. First one is file system. Second one is the processing environment and the building block primitives. We completed all these things yesterday. File system, these are the characteristics of file systems, how the file system is characterized by various features. This is shown in this slide. Then what is the actual architecture or the sample file system tree is shown in this slide. Everything is start with the root node, that is nothing but the root of the file system. Then some features of the file systems are given here, along with some of the very important and highlighted points related to the file system, like root node, non-leaf node, leaf node, path names, current directories, directories, access permission. And this is one of the sample program of copy a content of file from old file to the new file, that is explained here. Then comes the second feature, processing environment, where we learn what is process, what is program, what is executable file, how to create the child process using system call like fork, where you learn your first system call, that is fork, which returns two value, zero and non-zero. Zero is returned to the child process and non-zero is returned to the parent process. All these things are given here in this discussion or in this slide, where you can see this is a sample program for creation of the new child process by using fork. Yesterday we have seen this. And there one more system call you can see, that is nothing but the EXECL. Can anybody tell me what is the meaning of EXECL? Why this system call is used for, why this system, what is the need of this system call? EXECL, execute a file. Okay, here, this system call is immediately used after the fork system call, because whenever the fork system call create the child process, the child must execute something. Okay, you underline this sentence. The child, whenever the child is created, child must execute something, and that something is what? That is nothing but the program. So the child will execute the program. That program or the file can be given or executed by using EXECL system call. So that's why immediately after the fork system call, the EXEC, this system call is used. Okay. Then comes the last feature of Unix operating system, that is the high level features, building block primitives, where we have seen very two important primitives, the input output redirection and the pipes. Okay. So there is a standard input file, standard output file, and the standard error files. These three things are there. Okay. Which are easily handled by this input-output redirection. Pipe is again a command which is used to connect the two process. The output of one process can be given as an input to the other process by using pipe. So this also we have seen yesterday. Here there are some example of the pipe commands. And then today, I'm going to start the next article of your unit number one, that is the operating system services and assumption about hardware. Okay, so this is the title of today's assignment, today's article. My dear student, you can see operating system services. Okay, two things are there in this article. First one is the operating system services, and second one is assumption about hardware. So what do you think, what will be the services which will be provided by the operating system? Okay, operating system services, what will be the services of operating system? Okay, this is a very important point to discuss here. Here, if you remember the figure 1.1 where we discussed the architecture of the Unix system, okay, how many layers are there in Unix systems? How many layers are there in the architecture of the Unix system? Okay, nobody is replying. So there are four layers of Unix operating system. First one is the hardware layer, second one is the kernel layer, then third one is the commands, and last one is the other application program, that is outermost layer. Don't forget, there are four layers, right? From hardware, kernel, commands, and other application program. Okay, so you can see the kernel layer is there, the second layer, immediately below the layer of user application program. Okay, so this kernel layer is immediately below the user application program. Yes or no? So if you start from the outermost layer, the outermost layer is what? The first layer is outermost layer. We start from the outermost layer. Outermost layer, the first comes the other application program, and then comes the operating system commands, and then comes the kernel. Okay, so that kernel layer is very important. Kernel basically is nothing but the operating system itself. This you kindly keep in your mind. Kernel is basically a operating system. Kernel, sometimes generally you can see anywhere, if you Google it and if you see what is kernel, so somewhere you can find out the kernel is the heart of operating system. Okay, that is true. Kernel actually plays a very important role in operating system. Okay, that's why kernel itself sometimes called as kernel is a operating system. Okay, this is very important. So now, dear students, see, kernel performs various primitive operation on behalf of user process to support the user interface described. Okay, see, आपको कर्नल का एग्जैक्ट डेफिनेशन तो मैं यहाँ पे नहीं बताने वाला, बिकॉज वी कैन नॉट लिमिट और वी कैन नॉट क्रिएट अ बाउंड्री फॉर दिस कर्नल. कर्नल इज वेरी बिग, कर्नल इज वेरी वास्ट, कर्नल इज ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम. ओके, तो हम उसे किसी का लिमिटेशन में रख नहीं सकते. सो देर इज नो, आई विल नॉट गिव यू एनी सच डेफिनेशन, बट आई विल गिव यू द फीचर्स ऑफ योर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ दिस कर्नल. सो डियर स्टूडेंट, सी, दिस kernel performs various primitive operation on behalf of user process to support the user interface. Okay, so iska matlab kya hai ki whenever the user is performing any operation on computer system or on operating system, then kernel actually plays the very important role on behalf of user to support the user interface. Okay, so ye aapko lagta hai, mujhe lagta hai, end user ko kya lagta hai ki aap operating system ke sath communication kar rahe, but actually my dear student, it is a kernel हु इज वर्किंग ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ यूजर. इट इज अ कर्नल हु इज वर्किंग ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ यूजर एंड परफॉर्मिंग ऑपरेशन ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ यूजर. सो हियर एग्जैक्टली द सेम थिंग वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न, वॉट ऑपरेशन द कर्नल इज परफॉर्मिंग ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ यूजर. तो ये एक्चुअली ये डिटेल में जाने से पहले मैं आपको जनरली व्हाट ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम सर्विसेज, या भाई टाइटल क्या है अपना, ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम सर्विसेज. तो ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम सर्विसेज क्या क्या है इसके बारे में एक थोड़ी सी जानकारी देना चाहता हूँ. लाइक जनरली वी कैन से दैट ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम परफॉर्म द सर्विसेज लाइक मेमोरी मैनेजमेंट. ओके, मेमोरी मैनेजमेंट. Here I have written in the chat box, memory management. Then operating system perform the process management. Okay, you can see on the chat box. Operating system perform the file management. Okay, file management. Operating system perform the input output management. Okay, like this. Operating system perform the device management. Device management. Okay, kindly see the chat box. I am writing the services or the functions of operating systems. Operating system perform the synchronization. Synchronization. Okay. Operating system perform the synchronization. Operating system perform the inter-process communication. That is called as IPC. IPC, inter-process communication. Operating system perform the scheduling. Scheduling. Okay, scheduling. All these things are very important features of operating systems. Here, operating system perform the function like security. Security. Okay, security. Operating system performs the interrupt management, interrupt handling. Interrupt, okay, handling, handling. Okay, maybe the spelling is wrong there. Interrupt, but it is a interrupt handling. Interrupt. Okay, interrupt handling. So like this, operating system performs various function. Okay, so कुछ important and highlighted features यहाँ पे मैंने chat box में लिखे हैं. I again repeat it that file management, process management, memory management, device management, input output management, synchronization, inter process communication, scheduling, security, interrupt handling, and what means many more features are there that operating system can perform. Okay, so it is clear to everybody. So detail mein main aapko ye memory management, device management, file management, inter process communication, ye matlab this is actually there, but we are going to learn these things with respect to Unix operating systems. Okay, memory management, device management, file management, all, not only the Unix operating systems, Windows is also having this. Windows operating system also perform these operations or these services. Your Android operating system also provides you the memory management, process management, file management, input output management. Mac OS, every operating system gives this kind of services. This is very general. This is by default services provided by any operating systems. But now, dear students, see, we are going to learn all these operating system services with respect to the Unix and kernel. Okay, so that's why in this lecture or in this article, you can see these are the services provided by the kernel. Which services provided by the kernel? See here, first one is the controlling. Controlling is written in your screen. You can see controlling. Controlling the execution of processes by allowing their creation, termination, and suspension and communication. So we know what is meant by process. Process is an instance of program which is in execution. We yesterday discussed about how to create the process. Child process is created by using system called fork. So actually, kernel is controlling the execution of process by allowing their creation, termination, suspension, and communication. Okay, see the first services. Controlling the execution of the process by allowing their creation, termination, or suspension and communication. now you can see what is mean by process creation. So creation मतलब creation of child process जो हमने कल पढ़ा. Process termination मतलब you can terminate the process. Kernel can terminate the process. Okay, stop the process in between. So that is called as termination. Suspension, kernel can suspend the process. Kernel can one process can communicate with other process. That is called as process communication. So all these things comes under the controlling the execution of the process by allowing their creation, termination, or suspension and communication. So this is a very important service provided by the operating systems. So यहाँ पे आपका टाइटल क्या दिखाई दे रहा है? ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम सर्विसेज. एंड यहाँ पे आप पढ़ सकते हैं सर्विसेज प्रोवाइडेड बाय कर्नल. तो मैंने आपको क्लियर किया है कर्नल एंड ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम्स आर नॉट डिफरेंट. दे आर वन. देर आर टू नेम्स बट दे आर वन. कर्नल एंड ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम्स आर वन. ओके, सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. दिस इज नॉट अ टू डिफरेंट एंटिटी. ओके, कर्नल एंड ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम्स आर वन. So services provided by the kernel controlling the execution of the process by allowing their creation, termination, communication. Okay. Second service you can see on your screen, scheduling a process fairly for execution on CPU. So scheduling यहाँ पे chat box में मैंने लिखा था scheduling. Okay. So scheduling means schedule the process for execution. So who is responsible for scheduling the process for execution? The kernel is responsible for scheduling the process. And who is executing the process? CPU, CPU, Central Processing Unit, processor. Processor will execute that process. तो कल मैंने क्लियर किया था कि आपके कंप्यूटर में n नंबर ऑफ प्रोसेसेस एग्जीक्यूट होते हैं. बैकग्राउंड में तो आपने कुछ काम भी नहीं किया, तब भी बैकग्राउंड में बहुत सारे प्रोसेसेस एग्जीक्यूशन मोड में रहते हैं. So, इसको एग्जीक्यूशन में लाने के लिए मतलब दैट इज कॉल्ड एज शेड्यूलिंग द प्रोसेस फेयरली फॉर एग्जीक्यूशन इज डन बाय कर्नल. ओके, वन बाय वन द प्रोसेसेस आर गिवन टू द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम्स. सॉरी, वन बाय वन द प्रोसेसेस आर गिवन टू द सीपीयू एंड एग्जीक्यूट द प्रोसेस. डिफरेंट एल्गोरिथम हाउ दिस प्रोसेसेस आर गिवन. शॉर्टेज जॉब फर्स्ट, सीपीयू शेड्यूलिंग, देन फर्स्ट कम फर्स्ट सर्व, राउंड रॉबिन. तो दीज आर द वेरियस एल्गोरिथम्स आर द प्रोटोकॉल्स आर देयर दैट इज कॉल्ड एज शेड्यूलिंग एल्गोरिथम व्हिच आर यूज टू शेड्यूल द प्रोसेस फॉर एग्जीक्यूशन बाय सीपीयू. प्रोसेस शेयर द सीपीयू इन टाइम शेयर्ड मैनर. द सीपीयू एग्जीक्यूट द प्रोसेस. कर्नल सस्पेंड इट व्हेन इट्स टाइम क्वांटम इलैप्स. And kernel schedules another process to execute. The kernel later reschedule the suspended process. So see here. Now, dear student, whatever written in this paragraph, last paragraph, that is a time shared manner. So what is a time shared manner? See here, there is a time sharing system. Very important entity. You must remember this. Okay? Time sharing system. I am writing here in chat box. Time sharing system. So what is a time sharing system? Time sharing system is nothing but the actually what happening inside the operating system. See, a particular amount of time, that is nothing but the time slice. Okay, I am writing here in chat box time slice. Time slice. Time slice is a very short amount of time that is probably measured in terms of nanosecond. Okay, that is measured in terms of nanosecond. I'm writing in the chat box. You just see the chat box whenever I'm writing or typing there something. So a small amount of time in terms of nanosecond that is called as a time slice is given to each and every process for execution. Okay. And if during that particular time slice the process is completed its execution, then it is well and good. If process is not able to complete its execution within that time limit, then kernel suspend the execution of that process and kernel switch to other process. That is nothing but kernel schedules the another process to execute. And after the completion of that another process, then kernel reschedules the first process, which is suspended. Okay, this entire phenomena is called as time sharing system. तो आपकी जो लैपटॉप की सिस्टम है, मैं जो सिस्टम यूज करता हूँ, कॉलेज में जो सिस्टम है, एवरीवेयर ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड nowadays, whatever the computing systems are used, that is a time sharing system. Okay, आपका लैपटॉप, मोबाइल, आपका हैंड, जो भी हैंडहेल्ड डिवाइसेस, ऑल दीज आर नथिंग बट द टाइम शेयरिंग सिस्टम. टाइम इज अ पर्टिकुलर अमाउंट ऑफ टाइम, अ स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ टाइम इज शेयर्ड फॉर द एग्जीक्यूशन ऑफ ईच एंड एवरी प्रोसेस. रीड द पैराग्राफ वंस अगेन सो दैट यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड इट क्लियरली. ठीक है, प्रोसेस शेयर द सीपीयू इन टाइम शेयर्ड मैनर. ओके, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस? द प्रोसेस शेयर द सीपीयू इन टाइम शेयर्ड मैनर मीन्स, जैसे मैंने कहा यहाँ पे टाइम स्लाइस, अ स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ टाइम इज गिवन फॉर ईच प्रोसेस फॉर द एग्जीक्यूशन. ओके, एंड देन सीपीयू एग्जीक्यूट द प्रोसेस विद इन दैट टाइम. अगर दैट प्रोसेस इज नॉट एबल टू कंप्लीट इट्स एग्जीक्यूशन इन दैट टाइम स्लाइस, then kernel suspend that process. Okay, when its time quantum elapsed, time quantum, okay, time slice bhi likha tha maine, time quantum bhi another naam, quantum, time quantum. Okay, that is a small amount of time. Kernel suspend it when its time quantum elapsed means finish, and kernel schedule the another process to execute. The kernel later reschedule the suspended process. So this all operation will be done by the kernel. That is a very important feature of any kernel or operating systems. Are you getting what I am saying? Okay, समझ में आ रहा है आपको? Or if you are having any doubts in your mind, you can free to ask right now. Okay, what is meant by this second operation or first operation also? If you are having any doubts related to this first and second, so that we can continue to the next. Okay, any doubt up till now? Services provided by the operating system controlling the execution of the process by allowing their creation, termination, and suspension and communication, and then scheduling the process fairly for execution of the CPU. Process share the CPU in time shared manner. CPU execute a process. Kernel suspend it when its time quantum is elapsed. And kernel schedule another process to execute. The kernel later reschedule the suspended process. तो किसी को कोई problem है understanding करने के लिए, कुछ doubts, clarification you required, then you can ask me right now. Cyber predictor, can you change your identification? Cyber predictor, what is your name? Our name is Gaurav. Yes, Gaurav, kindly change your this identification so that I will come to know the name of the students. Okay, very good. So see what he is asking. Can any process executed through priority condition? Yes. Here, this yesterday I used one word or sentence that this is a big ocean. Operating system is a big ocean. So there are many more things. There are many more phenomena, concepts, then many more characteristics, many more things are there. See, why I use this sentence? Because we are going to learn the operating system and administration. Okay, operating system and concept. the name of the chapter is like this: operating system and concepts. So probably the syllabus will be different. Okay. Now our chapter, our subject name is operating system and administration. So all these things are related to the operating system and plus administration. Okay. How you can become an admin? Controlling, executing. Okay. So that is your job, no? So that's why these things are not there. But as and when the time is permit, I will definitely explaining you the related thing. जैसे कि अभी यहाँ पे सीपीयू शेड्यूलिंग का थोड़ा सा पार्ट आ रहा है, शेड्यूलिंग प्रोसेस। तो शेड्यूलिंग प्रोसेस का मतलब क्या है कि शेड्यूलिंग प्रोसेस मतलब देर आर एन नंबर ऑफ प्रोसेसेस एंड वन बाय वन द प्रोसेस इज गिवन टू द सीपीयू। वन बाय वन द प्रोसेस इज गिवन टू द सीपीयू सो दैट सीपीयू कैन एग्जीक्यूट दैट प्रोसेस। ओके, तो यहाँ पे ये सीपीयू इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर एग्जीक्यूटिंग द प्रोसेस, कर्नल इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर शेड्यूलिंग द प्रोसेस। ओके, तो देर आर वेरियस सीपीयू शेड्यूलिंग एल्गोरिथम। ये शेड्यूलिंग करने का तरीका भी अलग अलग रहता है, तो उसे हम कहते हैं एल्गोरिथम, सीपीयू शेड्यूलिंग एल्गोरिथम। तो कौन कौन से ऐसे एल्गोरिथम है, तो देखो, फर्स्ट वन इज लाइक देर इज अ शॉर्टेस्ट जॉब फर्स्ट। ओके, आई एम राइटिंग हियर इन चैट बॉक्स, हियर आई विल राइट द SJF, शॉर्टेस्ट जॉब फर्स्ट। ओके, फुल फॉर्म इज शॉर्टेस्ट जॉब फर्स्ट। तो जो जो प्रोसेस शॉर्ट है, ओके, तो सिंपल लैंग्वेज में मैं कह सकता हूँ कि जो प्रोसेस शॉर्ट मतलब सिंपल है, ओके, छोटी है, तो दैट विल एग्जीक्यूट फर्स्ट, शॉर्टेस्ट जॉब फर्स्ट। तो दैट प्रोसेस इज गिवन टू सीपीयू फॉर एग्जीक्यूशन। दिस इज वन एल्गोरिथम। सेकंड एल्गोरिथम इज फर्स्ट कम फर्स्ट सर्व। ओके, सी हियर, हियर आई एम राइटिंग FCFS, फर्स्ट कम फर्स्ट सर्व। तो जो कुछ फर्स्ट आएगा उसे पहले शेड्यूल करने करेंगे, फर्स्ट कम फर्स्ट सर्व। ओके, सीपीयू विल एग्जीक्यूट द फर्स्ट प्रोसेस विच शेड्यूल द फर्स्ट, देन कम द नेक्स्ट, देन कम द नेक्स्ट, लाइक दिस। देन देर इज अ राउंड रॉबिन, राउंड रॉबिन शेड्यूलिंग। ओके, राउंड रॉबिन शेड्यूलिंग समटाइम्स कॉल्ड एज RR, राउंड रॉबिन। तो राउंड रॉबिन मीन्स वन आफ्टर अनदर, मीन्स रैंडमली आई कैन टेल राउंड रॉबिन। ओके, राउंड रॉबिन मैनर। एंड अनदर वन इज प्रायोरिटी बेस्ड शेड्यूलिंग, प्रायोरिटी बेस्ड शेड्यूलिंग, व्हाट द गौरव इज आस्किंग। ओके, प्रायोरिटी बेस्ड शेड्यूलिंग, कैन एनी प्रोसेस एग्जीक्यूटेड थ्रू प्रायोरिटी कंडीशन, यस। सो दैट इज अ वन एल्गोरिथम, प्रायोरिटी शेड्यूलिंग। अ प्रायोरिटी इज गिवन टू ईच एंड एवरी प्रोसेस। नंबर वन यू विल बी एग्जीक्यूटेड, नंबर टू देन आफ्टर वन नंबर योर नंबर, नंबर थ्री, नंबर फोर, नंबर फाइव, लाइक दिस द प्रायोरिटी इज गिवन टू ईच एंड एवरी प्रोसेस सो दैट दे कैन बी एग्जीक्यूटेड बेस्ड ऑन द प्रायोरिटी। दैट इज कॉल्ड एज प्रायोरिटी बेस्ड शेड्यूलिंग। ओके, सो दैट इज देयर गौरव, प्रोसेस कैन बी एग्जीक्यूटेड थ्रू प्रायोरिटी, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज प्रायोरिटी बेस्ड शेड्यूलिंग। ओके, क्लियर विथ योर क्वेश्चन और एनीथिंग मोर यू वॉन्ट फ्रॉम माई साइड गौरव? यस, ओके। तो दिस इज द एल्गोरिथम्स, दैट इज ये एक्चुअली एल्गोरिथम आपके सिलेबस में अभी नहीं है, लेकिन अगर आपका सब्जेक्ट का नाम रहता है ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम एंड कंसेप्ट, देन वहाँ पे आपको ये एल्गोरिथम का भी स्टडी करना पड़ता। ओके, व्हाट आर हाउ द फर्स्ट कम फर्स्ट इज इम्प्लीमेंटेड, हाउ द शॉर्टेज जॉब फर्स्ट इम्प्लीमेंटेड, हाउ द राउंड रॉबिन, हाउ द प्रायोरिटी बेसिस। तो देर आर डिफरेंट एल्गोरिथम स्टेजेस, स्टेप्स। ओके, सो दैट्स वाई हियर आई एम मीन्स इवन दो आई मीन्स आई एम हैप्पी टू एक्सप्लेन ऑल दिस थिंग्स हियर, बट द टाइम विल नॉट परमिट अस टू एक्सप्लेन दिस थिंग्स, देन प्रोबेबली विल नॉट एबल टू कंप्लीट आवर रिक्वायर्ड पार्ट्स। गॉट इट? ओके, तो ये अच्छी बात है। आपको एक चीज़ यहाँ पे याद रखनी है कि कुछ चीज़ें आपको भी सेल्फ स्टडी करनी है, जैसे यहाँ पे मैंने चैट बॉक्स में लिखा है ये सब एल्गोरिथम्स के नाम, तो आप भी रेफर कर सकते हैं लिटरेचर, देर आर वेरियस बुक्स अवेलेबल ऑन इंटरनेट, गूगल यू कैन सर्च वेरियस थिंग्स रिलेटेड टू दिस, इफ यू शेड्यूलिंग देयर प्रोबेबली यू कैन कम टू नो हाउ दे आर एग्जीक्यूटिंग, गॉट इट? सो फाइन, सो दैट इज अ सेकंड एल्गोरिथम, सॉरी सेकंड सर्विस दैट इज गिवन बाय द कर्नल, शेड्यूलिंग द प्रोसेस. ओके, फर्स्ट वन इज कंट्रोलिंग द एग्जीक्यूशन ऑफ द प्रोसेस. नाउ व्हाट आई विल डू, आई विल चेंज द स्लाइड. Yeah, next one. Allocating the main memory for executing the process. Allocating the main memory for executing the process. Here, third service provided by the operating system. Allocating the main memory for executing the process. Kernel allows the process to share portions of their address space under certain conditions, but protect the private address space of process from outside tampering. If the system runs low on free memory, the kernel frees the memory. Okay, kernel frees the memory by writing the process temporarily to the secondary memory called swap device. If the kernel writes the entire process to the swap device, the implementation of the Unix system is called as swapping system. If it writes the page on the memory to swap device, it is called as paging. Okay, so now. Here, third important service provided by the operating system or the kernel, that is memory management. This is first one, that is scheduling is also very big. Controlling the execution of the process is also very big. There are many more things to discuss and communicate. Third one, this memory management, allocating the main memory for executing the process, that is called as memory management. So, ये memory management का काम भी operating system करता है. So, what is the memory management? So, see my dear student, आपने पढ़ा होगा, there are two types of memory, primary memory and secondary memory. Yes or no? Primary memory and secondary memory. So, primary memory is like your RAM. Okay, random access memory. Secondary memory is like your hard disks, pen drive, disk storage devices. This comes the secondary memory. Okay, so external memory, I'm saying the secondary memory. So normally, see, shortly, briefly, मैं यहाँ पे आपको explain करूँगा कि जो कुछ हमारा data रहता है, whatever the files and the programs we are having. That are first of all stored on the secondary storage device. मतलब क्या है कि जब आप प्रोग्राम बनाते हैं matrix.c for example, matrix.c, तो वो प्रोग्राम कहाँ पे रहता है? वो प्रोग्राम रहता है सेकेंडरी स्टोरेज डिवाइस पे, मतलब आपके हार्ड डिस्क पे स्टोर है. लेकिन जब आप उस प्रोग्राम को रन करना चाहते हैं तो आपको वो प्रोग्राम प्राइमरी मेमोरी में लाना पड़ता है. प्राइमरी मेमोरी मतलब रैम में लाना पड़ता है. कहाँ से लाना पड़ता है? सेकेंडरी स्टोरेज डिवाइस से, मतलब हार्ड डिस्क से उठाकर वो प्रोग्राम प्राइमरी मेमोरी रैम में आपको लाना पड़ता है, तब जाके वो प्रोग्राम एग्जीक्यूट होगा. तो कल परसों हमने डिस्कस किया था कि वॉट एवर इज इन एग्जीक्यूटिंग दैट इज कॉल्ड एज प्रोसेस. प्रोग्राम आपका हार्ड डिस्क पे था, आपने उस प्रोग्राम को प्राइमरी मेमोरी में लाया, सो दैट प्रोग्राम बिकम्स प्रोसेस. बिकॉज इन प्राइमरी मेमोरी एवरीथिंग इज एग्जीक्यूटिंग. प्राइमरी मेमोरी में सब कुछ क्या हो रहा है? इन एग्जीक्यूटिंग मोड. ऑल थिंग्स आर इज इन एग्जीक्यूटिंग मोड, एग्जीक्यूशन मोड इन द प्राइमरी मेमोरी. तो हर चीज अभी राइट नाउ वी आर कम्युनिकेटिंग विद गूगल मीट. ओके, सो माय पीपीटीज आर एग्जीक्यूटिंग, आवर कॉन्फ्रेंस इज एग्जीक्यूटिंग, ऑडियो कॉन्फ्रेंस. सो ऑल दिस थिंग्स करंटली एग्जीक्यूटिंग. सो दैट्स वाई The primary memory is playing the important role. आपके लैपटॉप पे भी प्राइमरी मेमोरी है, मेरे लैपटॉप में भी प्राइमरी मेमोरी है. सो दैट प्राइमरी मेमोरी इज प्लेइंग द इम्पोर्टेंट रोल इन एग्जीक्यूटिंग आवर गूगल मीट. दिस इक्वली हैपन्स विद योर प्रोग्राम्स, वॉट एवर द ऑपरेशंस वी आर परफॉर्मिंग ऑन लैपटॉप्स और ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम्स, दैट ऑल थिंग्स आर वेन एवर दे आर अंडर एग्जीक्यूशन they are executing in primary memory. Okay, so now उसके आगे जाकर मैं आपको एक चीज बताना चाहूंगा. प्राइमरी मेमोरी इज ऑर्गेनाइज इन टर्म्स ऑफ पेजेस, पेज 0, पेज 1, पेज 2, पेज 3, पेज 4, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज पेजिंग। मेमोरी इज ऑर्गेनाइज इन टर्म्स ऑफ पेजेस, पेजेस ईच पेज इज हैविंग अ प्रीडिफाइंड साइज लाइक 64 किलोबाइट, 64 KB। ओके, सो वन पेज इज ऑफ साइज 64 किलोबाइट। And like this, there are n number of pages depending upon the size of your RAM. So if your size of your RAM is 8 GB RAM, nowadays the today's laptop is having 8 GB RAM. So 8 GB RAM, that means you can calculate then how many pages will be there. 64 kilobyte ka ek page rehta hai. 64 kilobyte is the size of one page. And if your RAM, if your primary memory is of 8 GB, then that many number of pages are there in your primary memory. Okay, so then comes the address. Each page is having a address, that is called as address location, address space. Okay, because operating system requires the address of that page where your data is stored. Okay, maine kya kaha aapko कि मेमोरी इज अलोकेटिंग विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू पेजेस, ईच पेज इज हैविंग पर्टिकुलर साइज दैट इज 64 KB, एंड ईच पेज इज हैविंग अ एड्रेस। फॉर एग्जांपल 10000 इज द एड्रेस ऑफ फर्स्ट पेज, 10001 इज द एड्रेस ऑफ सेकंड पेज, 10002 इज द एड्रेस ऑफ थर्ड पेज। लाइक दिस द ईच पेज इज हैविंग अ address, and operating system access that page with respect to that address location. Okay, so all these things are internally arranged and they are available internally. That's why they protect the data from outside tampering. But what happens if suppose now you are having a 8 GB RAM is a very sufficient and very large size of RAM available, but jaise jaise hum hamare laptop pe software install karte hai, whenever we are having n number of programs and big softwares on our machine, then probably kya hota hai ki later on our memory become running out, means that memory is not sufficient for executing the number of programs simultaneously. That is called as multitasking. Okay, आप live streaming नहीं कर सकते, आपका ये जो video meeting चल रहा है उसमें आप अच्छी तरह से pictures नहीं दे सकते. So this happens because of the memory is running out. Then what happens? Then actually it comes the role of kernel or the role of operating system, where kernel frees some memory. Okay. You can write the sentence here. Okay, you can read the sentence written here. If the system runs the low on free memory, the kernel frees memory by writing the process temporarily on secondary memory. That is called as swap device. So kernel kya karega ki kuch jo unwanted pages hai, matlab pages matlab the unwanted information or the program from the primary memory will be swap out from primary memory to the secondary memory. Okay, jo abhi instantly required nahi hai wo data kernel, data matlab wo process kernel primary memory se nikal kar secondary memory mein rakhega, aur jo required process hai usko andar lega. Kis pe lega? Primary memory mein lega. That is called as swap in. Kya kaha maine? Two steps are there, swap out and swap in. Swap out का मतलब क्या है कि आपकी मेमोरी अभी मतलब यू आर नॉट एबल टू एग्जीक्यूट द प्रोग्राम करेक्टली, आपका प्रोग्राम आपका लैपटॉप हैंग हो रहा है, आपको थोड़ा कम स्पीड मिल रहा है, तो आप क्या करेंगे, मतलब कंप्यूटर क्या करेगा कि जो फिलहाल जो प्रोग्राम रिक्वायर्ड नहीं है उसको प्राइमरी मेमोरी से निकाल कर सेकेंडरी स्टोरेज डिवाइस पे रखेगा, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज स्वैप आउट। और जो आपको एग्जीक्यूट करना है उसे प्राइमरी मेमोरी में लाएगा, दैट इज कॉल्ड अ स्वैप इन, स्वैप आउट, स्वैप इन। तो ये जो प्रोसेस है वो कंटिन्यूअस होती है, कंटिन्यूअस। ओके, कंटिन्यूअसली द कर्नल इज स्वैप आउट द लिस्ट रिसेंटली यूज पेजेस और द पेजेस व्हिच आर नॉट करंटली रिक्वायर्ड एंड स्वैप इन द रिक्वायर्ड पेजेस इनटू द प्राइमरी मेमोरी। तो ये जो प्रोसेस है स्वैप इन एंड स्वैप आउट उसे कहते हैं स्वैपिंग, स्वैपिंग सिस्टम। ओके, यहाँ पे लिखा है सब कुछ। द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ द यूनिक सिस्टम इज कॉल्ड एज स्वैपिंग सिस्टम। इफ यू राइट द पेजेस ऑफ द मेमोरी टू स्वैप डिवाइस इट इज कॉल्ड एज पेजिंग सिस्टम। ओके, ये देर आर मेनी मोर थिंग। ओके, पर्टिकुलरली 60 मिनट लेक्चर इज नॉट इनफ टू डिस्कस अबाउट द एलोकेशन ऑफ द मेमोरी। ओके, आई कैन स्पीक ऑन फुल डे, वी कैन स्पीक ऑन एलोकेशन ऑफ द मेमोरी, बट मीन्स सम इम्पोर्टेंट पार्ट वी हैव टू डिस्कस हियर। अदरवाइज एज आई सेड दैट इट विल नॉट परमिट अस टू कंप्लीट आवर सिलेबस देन। बट द इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग्स आर हाईलाइटेड हियर, दैट इज द थर्ड सर्विस ऑफ द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, दैट इज अलोकेटिंग द मेन मेमोरी फॉर प्रोसेस एग्जीक्यूशन। तो इस सर्विस के बारे में किसी का कुछ प्रॉब्लम है, कोई अंडरस्टैंडिंग नहीं हो रहा है, समझ में नहीं आ रहा है, कुछ डाउट्स है तो आप पूछ सकते हैं। व्हाट इज द मेमोरी एलोकेशन, व्हाट इज स्वैपिंग स्वैप आउट, ओके, व्हाट इज पेजिंग, व्हाट इज स्वैपिंग। इफ यू आर हैविंग एनी डाउट यू कैन आस्क राइट नाउ। दिस इज थर्ड फीचर, थर्ड सर्विस प्रोवाइडेड बाय द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, दैट इज अलोकेटिंग द मेन मेमोरी फॉर प्रोसेस एग्जीक्यूशन। इन अदर वर्ड्स इट इज कॉल्ड एज मेमोरी मैनेजमेंट। कोई डाउट है किसी को, कुछ मेमोरी मैनेजमेंट का ये कंसेप्ट समझ में नहीं आया आपको? Or you can read it once again, you can read the paragraph so that you can understand, or you can, if you feel any doubt is there, you can ask. Okay. Now the next service, that is number 4, is written there, allocating the secondary memory for efficient storage and retrieval of user data. This service constitute the file system. Kernel allocate the secondary storage for user files, reclaim the unused storage, structure the file system in a well understood manner, and protect the user file from illegal access. So again, it is a part of memory management. In the previous operation, we have seen the primary memory, that is RAM. In this current week, we are seeing the secondary memory management, primary memory management and secondary memory management. So kernel is also responsible for managing the secondary storage device. Actually, the hard disk, secondary storage device, pen drive, hard disk, your storage devices. What it is saying, allocating the secondary memory for efficient storage and retrieval of user data. Okay, so kernel provides a secondary storage device. Allocating, provide means it allocate that secondary storage memory for efficient storage and retrieval of user data. This service constitute the file system. Kernel allocate the secondary storage for user files, reclaim the unused storage, structure of the file system in well understood manner, and protect the user file from illegal access. That is there. Next service you can see, allowing the process controlled access to peripheral devices such as terminal, tape drives, disk drives, and network devices. That is device management. So jo initially maine chat box mein likha tha, process management, memory management, scheduling, synchronization. So there are one more thing is there, device management. So the last sentence in this slide, you can see kernel allowing the process controlled access to peripheral devices such as terminal, tape drives, disk drives, network devices. Okay, all these things, peripheral devices can be controlled by kernel. Okay, that is one of the very important service provided by operating system. See, there is one notice come on the WhatsApp group right now. All the students of FY BTEC, SY BTEC, B and B are hereby informed that the offline classes will be commence from Monday, that is 15th February 2021. As per the guideline issued by Government of Maharashtra, Savitribai Phule Pune University Circular Number 34/2021. In addition, it is mandatory to submit the following details at the time of physical reporting to the institute. First one, that is consent form from the parents and the students. Medical certificate from physician stating that no corona symptoms and fit for attending the classes. Note the detailed timetable for be communicated by respective department, and it is instructed to adhere with COVID-19 guidelines, and wearing the mask is compulsory. Okay, so dear student, this is the current updates from institute that from 15th February, Monday, your classes, offline classes are going to start. Okay, provided that you have to submit the consent letter from the parents and medical fitness certificate from the doctor. Okay, so that is a very positive step towards starting the offline classes, physical classes from coming Monday. Are you happy with this notice? Yes, what is your opinion? Or you are happy with online classes? Sweta is saying that offline classes. Yes. Other students, what is your opinion? The online classes should be going on, or the offline classes you required? Pranav is saying offline. Rutuja saying offline. Yes. Yes, offline. Correct. Very good. Obviously, now it is almost a year completed when the physical classes were suspended in the month of March. 16th March was the last date, March 2020, when the classes were suspended because of COVID-19. And now, today means in 15th February, your classes will start, offline classes. So you have to report to your department, we have to report to your college. Okay. And then physical classes will start from coming Monday. So that is a very positive sign towards completion of your engineering education. That is required. Actually, physical, without this physical classes and physical learning, it's difficult to understand many more concepts. Okay. Online, we are having some restrictions. We are, even though online, this platform is also very good. Entire year, we completed the sessions by online means only. Okay. So to avoid this COVID, okay, the online was a very good attempt so that your work is also continued and syllabus also completed. So that was the notice. But again, we come back to our topic, that is memory operating system services. So first service is controlling the execution of the process. Second one is scheduling the process for execution by CPU. Third one is allocating the main memory for executing the process. Fourth one is allocating the secondary memory for efficient storage and retrieval of the user data. Next one is allowing the process controlled access to peripheral devices such as terminal, tape drives, disk drives, and network devices. Okay. Next. So next subtopic is assumption about hardware. Okay. So here actually first part is operating system services, and now second part is assumption about hardware. I will start this topic tomorrow in the tomorrow's lecture. Assumption about hardware. Here something we are going to discuss about user mode and kernel mode. What is happening in the user mode? What is happening in the kernel mode? That is explained in this article. Okay. So till the 6 minutes are remain, if you are having any problem or doubts on the topic so far completed, you can free to ask. Because if you start this second article, assumption about hardware, then again will not get the time to complete it. Tomorrow again we have to start this. So that's why I will not start it today. Tomorrow we will start the assumption about hardware. Any questions till today? Means whatever the syllabus topic is completed so far, any doubt, or you are having any problem or facing any problem to understand, not able to clear the concept, which doubt hai aapke mann mein, kuch questions hai to puch sakte hai aap abhi. No doubt. Some of the direct second year student, today I will add your roll numbers on LMS, where you can do that. You are able to do the attendance. Today I will complete it. The rest of the student, you continuously now mark your attendance on the LMS. Those who are facing the problem, they can mark the attendance on the Google Sheet, which is the link is already shared on the WhatsApp group. Okay. And unit number one, all the PPTs I have shared on the LMS as well. Online sessions, whatever we are delivered so far, that all recording is available on your LMS. Whenever you want to refer it, you can refer it. Any doubt or question so far? Okay. So, okay. Go to the LMS and mark your attendance. I stop here. Thank you very much for joining. Tomorrow we will see the fresh article, that is assumption about hardware. Okay. I will end the meeting. Thank you very much for joining.